Sonica and welcome back to our channel SS Easy Education. In today's video, we're going to complete lesson 25 and 26. And if we get more time, then I think we will also complete lesson 27 or even 28. So for now, let's start with lesson 25, which is we live in a global village. So let's go. And guys, did you enjoy reading about mobile and computer? Yes, I read that yesterday after the video and it was so good. So if you guys have read that, please write down in this video's comments, and also you can write down in that video's comments as well. So for now, let's just start today's lesson, which is we live in a global village. So number lesson 25, we live in a global village. Look at the picture and discard with your partner what you see in them. I see a village. In this picture, there are some school kids and there is an army officer here. I think he's teaching them about rules and regulations. And in this picture, I have no idea. I cannot guess what type of thing is it. Okay, this is your homework. And I think these are also army officer. But anyways, this is your homework. You will find out with your partner. Even you can find out with your family. And you will, after finding out, please tell me that, yes, I have found out about it. Number B, Sohan's uncle works in the army. At present, he is in Congo in a UN peacekeeping mission. Read his letter to and do the following activity. Dear Sohan, I got your letter 2 days ago, but I was very busy here, so I am late to reply. Congo is a Central African country. There is a violence among political groups, so our life here is challenged. We maintain peace and security. We distribute food, water, medicine to people. We sometimes build houses for them. We also teach children in small schools. Last week, I met an interesting young man. His name is Gurmit Singh. He was born in India. In his early childhood, he left for Singapore with his parents and he went to a Singaporean school. After a few years, he moved to Denmark and completed his school education there. For graduations, he went to the US and got a university degree. Then he left for the UK and completed his master's degree there. Gurmit came to Congo to work for a voluntary organization. His main job is to look after children's education in a community school. He belongs to the groups of 10 workers. They all came from different countries. He is a nice fellow and a good friend of ours. We call him Mr. Global Citizen. I am writing below the conversation I had with him the other day. You have been to so many countries. How about you? How do you feel about that? It's nice to work with different people. I've come to know them. The language, culture, family, mind. Sometimes I think I belong to all. Well, Gurmit, you're a true global citizen. Aren't you too so? Smile, Gurmit. We're all the same human members. Well, that's all for today. Hope your exam is over by now, so write to me soon. What do you think about it? With love, Uncle Zoo. Hey, I think, if anyone asks Mr. Gurmit Singh that, well, where are you from? He will tell, I was born in India, then I went for Singapore with my parents, and then I moved to Denmark to complete my education there, school education. For graduation, I went to the US and got a university degree, and then I left for the UK to complete master's degree, and now I am in the Congo, that means Africa Central Country, Congo, for a job, that means for voluntary organization. So that is a big word to answer. Just a little question, where are you from? But technically I think he's from India. B1, now match the words in column A with an A with their meaning in column B. Challenging, difficult, maintain, keep up, graduation, university degree, clash, fight, global, international. Now B2, read silently the text B again. What? I'll just skip it. Then ask and answer the following question. Where is Congo? Congo is an African central country, so it is in Africa. Who is called Gurmit Singh? Who called Gurmit Singh Mr. Global Citizen? Who are the friends of Mr. Gurmit Singh called Mr. Global Citizen? Because he has been to so many countries and have many experience there. Make a list of 5 questions you would like to ask to Gurmit. Listen to the CD or audio and fill the following gaps. And this is your homework for today, okay? Next is our wage earners. Look at the picture and the words in the following box. Discuss and see which words are relevant. First picture where there are so many people in luggages, it is related to foreign, abroad, tourist, and in pleasure, and the money is wage, worker, earner, job, economy, and etc. A huge number. Working pairs, ask and answer the question. Ask and answer the question first. Then read the following text to map with your answer. Why is there demand for Bangladeshi workers? Do you know what countries they work in? Can you guess why don't they earn much? Bangladeshi workers are really big demand of Bangladeshi workers, and they work in many countries like England, Malaysia, Nepal, Maldives. Yes, I'm saying true because one of my dad's friend work in Maldives and I love to go there. And my mom also worked in Nepal, Malaysia for a few months because for a presentation, and my mom would also go to Netherlands, Belgium, Vietnam, but for this COVID-19, my mom didn't go because now it's too dangerous to go to another country. I wish COVID was disappeared. I wish I had magic. Abracadabra. Boom, COVID, go, boom. And can you guess why don't they earn much money? I think they earn less because I don't know. Guys, I'm really confused for these 3 number questions. If you guys know the answer, please write down in the comments to get a heard from me. So, number of Bangladeshis go abroad for jobs. There are always a high demand of workers in some foreign countries like UAE, United Arab Emirates, Oman, Saudi Arabia, Qatar, Bahrain. Like they are like Bangladeshi workers because they are hard work. But this is a matter of forget that our workers are doing odd jobs. So they're not paid much. This is because our workers are not good at English, Arabic, or other language. This is really not good, really. So, I think now I'll have to give so many English courses to you guys so that you can really learn English really nicely. So, please subscribe English. I'll just not provide my books English. I'll also provide some other English lessons. So please subscribe and click the bell icon so you'll be really good at English. So anyways, so we should develop language skills of our workers in the for the country they go for work. If they can develop their language skills, they can get good jobs, send more money to our countries, raise the wage earners of our country, and develop our economy. Complete the column B of the following table with information from the text above. Numbers of the workers go to above a job. Skills required for good job abroad. Countries preferring Bangladeshi workers. Wage earners of our country can. This is your homework. This is so easy. That's why I'm giving you homework. See, Sohan had conversation with Bangladeshi doctor Mr. Arman, who works in a hospital in Cairo, Egypt. Read the and practice the dialogue in there. Sohan, can you tell me a little about Cairo, Dr. Arman? Sure. What do you know? Like to know? Sohan, what's a good time to visit? I think Dr. Arman. I think you can visit anytime. The weather is more or less the same. Sohan, good. What should I see there? Dr. Arman, well, you can visit the Cairo Museum and you should see the mummies. You mustn't leave Cairo without visiting the pyramids. Sohan, anything else? Oh yes, if you have time, you can visit Port Suez. You can have an excellent night view of the Red Sea. Sounds exciting. Thank you very much. Ooh, I really want to visit Cairo and watch pyramids. Mal, language focus. Mal verbs can, can't, couldn't, may, should, must. Can you tell me something about Cairo? Yes, I can. No, I can't. What else should I do? You could enjoy the night view of Port Suez, but you should. Couldn't go across the Red Sea without valid visa. What can I have for dinner? You can have traditional Egyptian dishes or continental European as you wish. What should I see in the Cairo Museum? You should see the mummies, but you mustn't leave Egypt without visiting the pyramid. D. Complete the sentences about what a tourist can do and see in the Dhaka. Use the verbs from the box. Can see, makes, paints, can go, could even test, shouldn't miss, should visit, should go for, mustn't drink, may try, you should visit, you should go, you should visit Sharanga. You must see the capital of ancient Bengal there. You can see, you have to visit the Lalba Fort in the old part of Dhaka. You can stay a couple of hours at the Balda Garden. You can also visit the Asan Manjil too. You can have a boat ride on the Burganga River. You can have the test of Mughlai Khana once you're in Dhaka. You can ride a tom-tom ride from the Sadarghat to Gulistan. You can eat chatpati or futka on the footpath, but you shouldn't drink the tap water in a restaurant. Read the sentences in section D 1 to 10 again. Suppose Gurmit Singh wants to visit Dhaka. He wants some information from you, such as when to visit, what to see, where to eat, what to do in Dhaka, etc. Complete the following dialogue, taking the key of so this is your homework, okay everyone? So the next one is 27, but we are supposed to only read 20 from 25 and 26. And guys, and we also don't have that much time now, so it's time to say bye-bye. So friends, thank you so much for watching. Don't forget to smash the subscribe button and turn on the bell so you miss any awesome videos like this video. also subscribe, like, and share. And please pray for me so I can heal my broken leg quickly. And my leg is not just broken, it's also cut it really, really deeply. So here is the picture. Look, this is so badly cut it also. So I also need to stitch it. So please pray for me so I can heal it really quickly. Thanks guys, bye. See you in the next video.
So Allah Hafiz everyone. Meet you soon inshallah. Allah Hafiz. Subscribe to SS Easy Education and also click the bell icon. Send me any awesome videos like this video.